Usually when we pray, we use the words, Lord God, protect me, guide me, and bless me. These are the words that God wants to hear from us. But, in fact, these are, He wants us, that we should say to Him in our daily lives.
Mm-hmm. But does it stop there? Is prayer one way? We only talk to God, or is it two-way? We also learn to listen to God. How do we know? Together, let us discover. Dire lang sa,
Let's Pray Pilipinas!
Kasing ko, handog na ako, upan ka lang.
Good morning, mga kapaglaom.
Higala, kumusta og may buntag? Ano sabta kita sa atong udlaw, unang adlaw sa atong semana? Adlaw ang Domingo may kailaan, pinakaunang adlaw, gikalipay na to sa pagsugat nining bag-o nga semana. Inubanan sa presensya sa Ginoo o karon mga kailaan. Kamu nga na sa mga panimalay karon, wake up na o ipadalaan na sugod ang iyong prayer request o mga prayer support. Ano kita karon, ang ato ng hotline number, iga pakita karon sa inyong atubangan, sa inyong mga screens, busa diha igala, nakakaroon, nakapagawas na. I-text diha ang inyong mga prayer support o mga prayer request kay malipay migsuon din kami makabuhat ang mga special nga pag-ampo alang kaninyo. Ikalipay usab namo nga kita karon sa mga wala o sa mga walay mga television screens or dili maabot atong mga signal sa atong television diha. Good news because ang Let's Pray Pilipinas is live through Facebook. So kamo nga sa mga panimalay karon through Nanamino, through Hope Radio, nga gusto mo makita og video, please go to Let's Pray Pilipinas page sa ato ang Facebook. Og makigalan, mag-inat-anay ta dito, pinagi aning ato ang gitawag na to ng online streaming.
Yes.
So makigalan, aduna pa kita bisita. Sian?
So ato prayer partner for today, mga higala, none other than, she's an AY leader and also AY leader po siya sa isa ka-association which compasses 18 churches. So, mga higala for today, we have higala Ivan May Akum.
Yes.
Hi, Ivan, good morning.
Ivan Akum. So, siya makagilaan. Siya ito maka-open for
prayer
this
partner.
Morning.
Yes.
Yeah. At the same time, nalimtan, wala lang siguro gibutang, but she's actually part of Let's Pray.
Yes, she's a scriptwriter.
She's a scriptwriter of Let's Pray Pilipinas, makagilaan. And Van, we're so happy that you have ikaw na uban karon for this morning.
Yay.
Anyways, makilan, atong pagasugdan kini ato ang programa pinagi sa pag-ampo at ang hingon si Eva, tong guest, to pray for the opening prayer for our program this morning.
Okay, before we could pray, I'd like to say hi to my mom. I think she's surprised that I'm here. Good morning, Ma. I love you. Thanks for being calm. Okay. And good morning, sa ating viewers. Now, let's bow our heads and let's pray. Father in heaven, we would like to open this program with thankfulness in our hearts for the love that you had to us and to your children. Father, you have used Jeremiah in his teens and also Daniel. You have worked with these young people, and as we would serve you this morning, we pray that the Holy Spirit would be with us to guide us in each of the words that we would talk to. And may it would bring blessings to us and to the listeners and to the viewers. This we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, gilaan. So kami karon tulo, mahimo inyong prayer partners for this morning. And I know nga inyong makita, makagilaan nga, I'm the only thorn among the roses. So, gikalipay na to mga kaisunan, diin sila. Mga batanon, mga kaisunan, itawag na youth power, mao magkapahigayon karon sa ato nga prayer sessions for this morning. So, makikilan, doon na kita yung mga discussion nga itong nabuhat kagahapon. Unya, ang itong ipagsasupayan karon. Busa, ibutang sa inyo mga papel, kuha yung mga cellphones, ito ni sulat mixon kung gusto mo, kung comfortable mo sa cellphones
yes.
Or sa paper. Nani ato mga pipila ka mga punto aron kayo karong kabuntagan mixon.
So in connection gahapon, no, so yesterday we talked about Numbers 14.
Yes.
Atong ang mga Israelites, they were almost nagyud sa land of Canaan, and unfortunately, they murmured and then they neglected God's promise nga God will bring them to Canaan yud. So because they were overwhelmed sa kadagko sa mga tao dito, and they were scared actually. So for today, we will try to learn, no, how to avoid such thing in our own lives.
Nga,
okay. How will we do it? Nga, we will also take hold of God's word and His promise truth for today. So, mga higala, our first principle for today is that listening is a big deal.
Yeah.
How do we describe listening, Kuya?
Listening. Nandun na mag-iduha ka pa maagi yung listening. Nagitawag na siya yan na minaw na po'y nakadungog.
Ah, okay.
Hearing, listening. When we say hearing or nakadungog, nakadungog lang siya dali, labay pikas. I just heard, for example, nakadungog ko og something noise or some words. Muna itawag hearing, Lahi siya sa listening. When we say listening, when the message goes through here, it will stuck up here. Muna, and when it stuck up here, it results to action.
Okay.
Muna difference siya. When we say listening, makaisunan. So, dako siya part. And atong, kukutanan natong guest, Megson.
Yes.
Atong guest, Van, can you say something more about listening? A big deal.
Okay. Yeah. As a communication graduate, sigimig talk. Mm-hmm. And I just realized lately how important is listening. And according to books, we are prone to just talk and talk. Okay? We have like oration book. We have books about poems. So we just talk and talk. Speaking. But do we have book for listening?
How to listen.
Yeah. So, and most of the communication, pag mas dako ang imuhang listening skill, mas gamay ang kagubot sa panimalay, according to some facts. So, listening is a big factor. Now, point here is that how do we practice it in our prayer lives?
Yes.
And how do we practice it on our study? Listening. We cannot see our God. Can we listen to Him? Yeah. Can we hear Him?
Okay, actually, ako, bisag ako, I do the talking sa prayer. Merg na yung tendency bitaw nga, ay Lord, please give me, please guide me to do that. I do the talking and then, okay, wait, this is two-way. God should do the talking too. Have we experienced that? How do we experience that? Kanang God also talks.
And now a question ba sa inyo both. Is listening, yan na ba siya kalisod ba sa mag-listen? Lisod ba siya? Ang listening, lisod ba na siya buhaton or di?
Listen
siya bata or dito? Basta niya,
what
personal,
kind of listening?
Listening to God. Kung kami mag-talk. Kasi, you know, is listening to God hard? Basta niya? Or,
as we study in our quiet time, di ba, we pray and then we allow Him to talk to us. There are two parts sa basing o bisag unsa lang ato ang kanang madunggan, but there are two basic factors that you need to consider when we listen to God in prayer. The first thing is that it has to be coming from His Word. So, kung inyong prayer and then all of a sudden you think, kinahalan, bulagan na ako akong asawa. So, that is not biblical. So, you have to consider because this one, it comes through the impression of the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And then, so it has to be according to His Word. Dili dapat sukuhay isayang word. Mm-hmm. And ikaduha, you can also consider how God have led you in the past. Mm-hmm. Kung yun sa kanya pag-bless, that's the same principle that He would bless you in the same thing. So you will get a guide of how you can grow your prayer lives in a process.
That was important katong sa first part bitaw nga. It must come through His Word. Like what Romans 10:17 says, no?
Okay.
So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the Word of Christ. So we actually, it's like ngay gala, listening to God when we open the Bible and
so faith, say mo pang ibasa niya, faith comes from hearing. Pinaminaw man ta, it was God talking to you, and you heard, okay, itawag na to na siya nga, God, di man ta kanungog sa voice, you know, for sa ato nga panahon karon. So God says His Word through the Bible. Okay, so on. Through the Bible, God says, gasturiya siya sa ato. This is a two-way relationship. Gasturiya ta siya, God also talks to us through the Bible and through the Holy Spirit with a still small voice. So nasa idadaiya ang mga pamaagi makilaan, magasturiya ang Ginoo, and all we need to do is to open our ears, maminaw ta, if makalungog ta, listen to it. Pag mag-listen, then go.
Yeah, there was a story I have learned last year. It's coming from one of the great pastors we had, Pastor Pavel Goya. He's a Romanian pastor. Then one of his prayers every day is that he prayed, Lord, how can you use me today to help others? So how will he know that? He has to focus every day na the Holy Spirit could speak to him. And then one time in a winter, ang snow dito is taga kanang level sa window silang car. So he was driving. And then all of the sudden, ang Holy Spirit impresses him to turn his head to the right. And then, tapos siyang wipe siya, honey, there's something white over there. Ano iyang asawa nga, Are you crazy? It's no, it's of course white. Yeah. And then, no, I saw something really white. And then, okay, let's go there. And then they go there, and then all of a sudden, kita sila og patient nga naka-white. Mm-hmm. And then, nade siya sakit nga kanang mawala iyang memory ba? Mm-hmm. And then, they get him and then put him back to the hospital. And the doctor said nga, if minutes wala siya nakitan, he would be dead. Because it was cold. Mm-hmm. So that one, the Holy Spirit could talk to us and could, God could use us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So makigalaan, kumusta man ang atong pagpaminaw sa pulong sa Ginoo? Are we listening? Are we listening to Him? Naminaw ba ta siya? Or are we reading the Word of God, mm-hmm. which is the Bible? So makigalaan, ang pagpaminaw kay dako gayon ni siya o katabang, especially sa itong pagto. Now, let's proceed now to our point number two. Mm-hmm. Can you state the point number two, ma'am, Ivan?
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Our point number two is pride is a block to know God.
Okay. Pride is a block to know God. When we say pride is a block, meaning pride can hinder communications to God. Mm-hmm. Now, let's talk more about this. Sean, do you have any comments about this? Mm-hmm.
So pride, no, I think this is specifically talking about seeing ourselves nga dili bitaw ina na ka-need. Like I'm fine, I'm better off. And like the example siguro like usahay our prayers can be selfish. So like possibly nga naay mga times na we compare ourselves to others too. No? So would you like to say something? So na po yung mga times na we like nang katong sa publican o sa Pharisee nga prayer no nga ang nahitabo di adto
the Pharisee.
The Pharisee was like trying to compare himself sa publican nga I'm better than him, Lord. I'm not like a sinner like him. I do things right. I obey you and that thought, that mentality, pride goes. It's like hindering us from feeling that need of God, of knowing Him.
So, you can say something?
Thanks for elaborating that, Sean. And every week, we also have a small group sa among community. Mm-hmm. And the tendency is that sometimes, among discussion, ma-drive bitaw o kanang lantaw sa sayup sa uban. Right. Mm-hmm. Instead of looking in our own. So, I was like praying up. Lord, I hope it would get into a point nga we could stop looking on others kanang
faults.
Yeah, faults kanang when we read the word and then oh si kuan jud ni wala but it should unta no yeah it unta moabot sa point ba nga Lord dili ko ingani ring ana ba nga nay hunger bitaw. So that's where we see ourselves and God could work, but the thing is with the Pharisee is that he knows he was good. So it's like in a glass filled with water, you are the glass. So if we don't know how to re-empty ourselves, it's too impossible. It says in some that we have to open our mouth wide open so God could fill us. But if we are so sufficient and we think we are good, we don't need so much of God, then God cannot fill us.
Mm-hmm. And there's a quote, Steps to Christ, page 31. No? The Pharisees boastful, self-righteous prayer showed that his heart was closed against the influence of the Holy Spirit. He felt no need and he received nothing.
So in other words, pride, dako gyud siya nga babag sa ato ang drive. Because through pride, ato man lang gina-empty atong self, gina-feel atong self more of ourselves. So gyapon, murag ang self, more of self. Mo man ang equation makigilaan. God in, self out. If self in, God is out. And if we fill ourselves with self, atong ginadayig po minti itong kagalingon, I don't need God, I can handle this, kaya na ko isang kagalingon, tanan butang, last option lang ako, Ginoo na lang ang last option, that becomes a hindrance now that the Holy Spirit will come sa itong kinabuhi. And that is muna ang kadlukan na to sa to ang makigalaan. If mas na-think na to nga we can do better than God can do for us.
Yeah. There's a connection as a first principle and a second principle. I just got it now. So like, we really have to see to it. Let's pray good. This pride, it will also hinder us from listening to God. Nakabantay mo mga tao. Ako nakabantay ko mga tao mga istorya. And then afterwards, ang isa sige istorya, sige istorya, istorya. Nobody wants to listen.
Okay.
And that hinders from the other person. Kung saan gusto niyo ingon. Like, gusto na ako ipagawa sa kung gusto ako.
It's a they just listen to reply. They don't listen to understand.
Yes.
It's
different. So this is like very crucial.
Yeah.
When self is in, when self is being put into that pedestal, God can be like.
Yes, makigalaan ang atong diskusyon at ang ipagalayon unya. Busa ayo sa maghawa tungod kay sa unahan higson. Magabalik ang ato ang Let's Pray, kauban sa Let's Pray visit, atong pagkatanawon na sa unya, and ato ang mga prayer requests, atong prayer support, atong buhat ng pagampo, pilagi sa pag-text o sabi niyo sa atong ang hotline number, so please don't go away, magabalik pa ang iyong prayer partner, ang Let's Pray Pilipinas.
Gala, you're back to Let's Pray Pilipinas. Karon uban na nato si kapaglaong Jay Policarpio, no? Nag-visit siya dito sa Hinguog. Atong tan-awon kung kinsa ang iyahang naubanan, nadunggan nga story, and then how God answered her prayers. Let's watch this.
From the noise of the city to the whistling breeze of the sea, from something to nothing, to a miraculous blessing. This is how God transits the life of Esther Kaplis. Let's pray. Visit Advent Beach Camp, Kimaya, Magsaysay, Misamis Oriental.
Ma'am Esther, thank you so much for welcoming us here.
Sir Kay, it's my pleasure na nandito kayo ngayon at mag-interview sa akin. You are very, very much welcome here, kagaya ng mga ibang tao na welcome naman.
Thank you so much. Can you share to us what is your prayer story?
Actually, hindi talaga ako taga dito sa Mindanao. Tagalason ako, and I am asking the Lord why, bakit dinala ako dito. So, oo, noong nandun ako, I was an administrator really. School administrator. Tapos, nung pagdating ko dito, ang nakita ko ay bakery na walang manager, na ang mga iba, walang baker.
How about the place?
And the place ay wreck. Sabihin ko na lang ha. Wreck Beach. Wreck Beach. Na. So, ang tanong ko sa Panginoon, Lord, why did you bring me here? After so many days na ganun, ang mga problema, dahan-dahan na nakikita ko mga problema. So para bang, bakit po nandito ako? Ang mga problema ganito. So,
how will you say that prayer is effective? Because you pray.
Yeah. You know, sir, it's already my practice. Nung pagdating ko dito, na this is where the place that I practice to communicate with the Lord.
Ano ba yung pinaka hindi mo malimutan na experience sa life?
Like nung nasa Luzon pa kami,
yes.
Nang bibiyahe kami na pupunta ng Ilocos Sur. That morning, ihatid niya kami doon, we met an accident. At ito nga nangyari dito sa mukha ko, mayroon akong mga peklap-peklap.
Okay.
At doon,
naoperahan ka? prayer?
Oo, ito. Kasi dito, may pumasok mga bubog dyan. Iyon yung mga tinanggal-tanggal nila. Kaya gano'n. Oo. Yung experience na yon talaga yon ang isa sa hindi ko makalimutan. Sabi ng mga doon sa mga accident place na lahat na na-accident doon ay namamatay. Kami lang ang nakasurvive. So yun, I thank the Lord really. Kasi na-feel ko, ha, na Panginoon ang nag-guide. Kasi bakit buhay pa ako na dapat patay na sa ganitong sitwasyon ko?
Do you think there is what we call lesson that really changed you or who you are from the past when you pray to God? Ano ba yung mga lesson na ako?
Noong nandun ako sa Luzon, you know, kung sino ang administrator, di ba?
Yes.
Kung isa kang administrator,
yeah,
medyo...
Level na talaga.
Level, oo.
Yeah.
At yung, basta alam mo na,
yeah,
ha? Pero dito, iba ang level ko dito. No? Parang nasa lower part. So, yun ang difference. Ngayon na na-realize ko na ganun pala doon. Na, para bang may pride. Ha?
Okay.
Para bang may pride. Siyempre, ang tao nakatingin sa iyo, you're
yes,
an administrator.
Yes, that's correct.
Nakatingin sa iyo. So, yun parang may pride. So, nagpapasalamat ako sa Panginoon. At ito pang reason kaya nandito ako. Nakita ko na yung reason bakit dinala ako dito.
What is that?
Yung pride ko na alis. Siyempre, before you cannot see me like this.
Yes.
Oo, hindi ganito ang itsura ko. Pero ngayon, na praise the Lord at natutunan ko na magpakumbaba. Magpakumbaba. And this is the place where I met the Lord, really. Wala akong panahon sa Kanya. Puro busy sa work, busy sa work. Pero dito, nagkaroon ako ng panahon sa Kanya.
What is your message to them?
Huwag ninyong pabayaan na ang isang araw na wala kayong panahon sa Panginoon. Kasi yan lang ang number one secret para tayo ay maproteksyonan, tayo ay mablessingan, may blessing para sa atin. Ang ating spiritual life ay mag-grow. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Do you have your prayer request?
Ang mga anak ko, syempre, na nasa malayo sa akin.
Always.
Oo. Sana ipanalangin mo sila. You know, Sir Jay, yun ang lagi ko rin pinapanalangin. At yun ang aking aim na ang mga anak ko madala ko sa paanan ng Panginoon.
Yes, yes.
Sa kanyang pagdating. At isa pa, ang aking mga neighbors dito.
Yes.
Or in my mission, sentro ng ating mission ay dito sa Kimaya, ang aking mga neighbors.
I will request you to bow your heads and let us pray. Gracious Lord, Father in Heaven, we thank you for the presence of Mom Esther. Thank you for the time that we have.
The Bible says, and all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you if you obey the voice of the Lord your God. This is Jay Policarpio for Let's Pray Visits.
Maraming salamat kay Paglaom Jay sa inyong pagbisita ka, Ma'am Esther. Ma'am Esther, thank you so much sa imuhang experience. Mutong itawag siya introduction from something to nothing, from the noise of the city.
It's connected.
To, yeah, to the breeze beside the sea. Makagilan, atong ikalipay gayod si Ma'am Esther sa iyang experience. And we will pray for you shortly in a while. But before that, ato na tayong mga prayer requests at napagabasahon. But before I'll read first the prayer request, ato na greetings makigsunan. Igan kang Ralph Nakano Kahimto, na siya kanon sa Japan. So, he's greeting from Japan. Ohayo gozaimasu. Yeah. Ohayo gozaimasu. Now, igan po sa kang Rotich Milan, greetings also from Doha, Qatar. So, we'll greet
hello
everybody nasa dito. Stand viewers at ulas sa lain nga mga nasod. So, good morning sa tanan. And let's proceed now to our prayer request. First, igan kang Rotich Milan, pray for my plans to go through. I'm planning to go to Australia for further studies so that may God open ways. Also part for my family in Kenya and all the Seventh-day Adventist Church across the world. So, aduna pala in prayer diri, bikan kang Hira. She would like to pray for the upcoming national assessment in situ this coming November with her desires that she will be successful. And so us with her friend, nga si Shani Lee Jane nga adunay buslot sa iyang heart. So ato siya napil sa pag-ampo. Gikan usab kang Jean Caldena, ihang ipasalamatan. Then sa first semester, natapos niya first semester, but he likes also to pray that karong umalabot ng October 24th, that will be tomorrow, sa iyang assessment nga mapasar po siya. So atong i-pray ni sila makisunan, inubran sa pag-ampo.
Okay, so naapod din, no? But before reading, I'd like to greet happy birthday to my auntie, Auntie Flor, and to my brother, Gigi. Happy birthday. May God really bless you and guide you how to remember the things God did for you and will be doing for you. So, Nadri, my warning sa inyo, brother and sister, ako po si Liza Habagat. Unta, ma-pray ko ninyo na mawala ni akong sakit sa akong puson o kilid. Wala akong kabalog unsa na ni siya, taod-taod na ni akong gibati. And also, good morning, happy day, Pastor and Ma'am, si Jolene Josol ako name. Magpa-pray ko, Pastor, exam na ko today sa civil service. Okay. Please, Pastor, pray for us nga mo take sa civil service. Thank you so much and may God bless you. Apil na po diri si Brother Ariel Aninyon, kaoban yeah. nato, diri Cruz. So let's pray. Mm-hmm. And to everybody nga mag-take the civil exam, we will offer a special prayer for you.
And I have with me here two prayers. The first one, Ganan Tani. It says here, good morning, Ma'am, Sir. Always ko ga watch sa inyong program.
Wow, praise God.
God bless. Gusto ko magpa-pray always. Hinaot nga karong interview na mo, November 7 para sa Japan, sa Manila, makapasar me para makatabang ko sa ako ang ginikanan. His name is Dennis. And yes, Dennis, we will pray for you. And thank you for watching. Let's pray. Yeah. And the other one, please pray for me nga malayo ko sa tentasyon o mawala ni sa ako nga kahimtang. Okay, I can relate to this. So I could really pray for you.
Okay, so makigilaan at ang buhatan ng mga special na pag-ampo. Sean will start, Ivan next, and then we will end the prayer. So makigilaan. So we are inviting you. Come on, Panimbaya. Please join us in prayer.
Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much, dear Lord, for today. Thank you for waking us up, for giving us another day to see your goodness, Amen. To see and behold your mercy, your loving kindness to all of us. Dear Lord, we thank you for this privilege also of coming together in praying, realizing, dear Father, of our great need of you. As a father, dear Lord, we come to you as your children. We know, Father, that now you are looking down to us. We're in heaven and our hearts also are lifted to heaven. This is a special moment, dear Lord, where we can come together. Earth and heaven come together with the power also of the blood of Christ. This can all be seen by faith. Dear Lord, today we'd like to pray specially for Liza Habagat, na siya ginahambing nga sakit, Father, na lain ang iyahang kilid, ug dugay-dugay na niniya nga ginabati. Dear Lord, wala siya kabalo, wala pud mi kabalo kung unsa iyang ginabati. Now we pray that you will give her light, bless her, Father, with wisdom, and send her people so that ma-diagnose niya kung unsa man galing iyahang gibati and be mahatagan og ample nga unsay dapat buhaton aron kini mawala. But for now, Father, if wala pa ni siya, I pray that you'd bless Ma'am Liza sa iyang lifestyle, give her light, help her to see the sunshine, and with her diet, make her eat more organic foods and make her heart cheerful, because a merry heart doeth good like a medicine. We'd like also to pray for everybody nga mag-take sa civil examination, especially for Ariel Aninyon and Jolene Josol. Today, Father, as they take the examination, may they surrender their hearts, take their anxieties and their stress. Help them to remember the things that they've learned and the things that they've read. I pray, Father in heaven, that as they spend this the examination times, I pray also that they'll do what will glorify you. Help them to trust in you and help them also to obey you, Father in heaven, like they will not be tempted to do anything against your will. Father, we take hold that our prayers will be answered in faith. We know that you are hearing us and that through the blood of Jesus Christ, Our prayers will be answered with the forgiveness of our sins. In His name, we pray.
Father, as I continue to pray, I'd like to intercede for the life of Brother Dennis. He's been diligently watching Let's Pray, so I pray that you would continually bless him and his family, that they would know how to cultivate our prayer lives so that we could glow it in talking to you. And Father, you know his plan, the desires of his heart. He has his plan to help his family. Japan, and they will have an interview, and he is desiring a makapasar. Father, you are the God who sees everything and who has the best plan. So I pray that he would be able to learn the desire that you want him to have, and that whatever happens, he will be stayed on faith in you, and he knows how to trust you more, whatever trying situation that would come in his life. And I pray, oh Father, that you would give him the best gifts that you have for him, that he could discern your will for him. And also I pray for Sister Lizelle. Lord, she is having a hard time with a temptation. Father, the temptation will only become a temptation when we like it. If we don't like it, it is not a temptation anymore. So I pray, oh God, right now that you would help her how to hate this sin. Give her an understanding of how bad this will be for herself, that she would depart from it, and that Father, restore in her the joy of salvation, create a new heart in her. And we would like to take the promise that there was no temptation taken to man nga dili mi maka-escape. So Lizelle, you could hold that promise, and I will continually pray for you. This we bring to the name of Jesus Christ.
Sa pagpalain, O Diyos, nandunan na kami pipila ka pangalan na gusto ng midos sa mga trono. Nandunan na kami mga kaisunan na doon ibalatian, mga kaisunan na mo na gusto sila ng mga plano na gusto na isangat na isimong trono. Kinibulo kami kung among plano na simuha, ang pinakamaayong plano mo'y may tabuan lang ka na mo. Inidak na, O Diyos, nakita ni mo si Hira. Ado na siya dako nga pang handom nga siya unta makapasar sa iyahang giandaman nga assessment and sito karang umalabot ni Nobyembre. Hatagi siya kaalam, O Diyos. Diin ka ang kaalam nga among gikinahanglan dili ni siya nagagikan ka na mo kung dili kagikan ka ni mo. Tungod kaya ang among kaalam, hamubo lamang, limitado, apan kung ikaw maghahatag ni O Diyos, inubanan sa iyong pagtugot, siya makapasar, makapadayon sa pagsirbisyo sa pamilya, uglabaw na O Diyos sa pagsirbisyo ka ni mo. Ginampusap na mo, si Rotich Milan. Adun na siya plano usab nga magpadayon siya sa iyang pagtuon dito sa Australia. Amahan, kani nga pagtuon nga among gi panghanday, dili ni siya alang sa kagulingon lamang kundi para usab sa tibok pamilya o para usab mahimo siyang instrumento sa paggamit nimo. Sa paggamit nimo kaniya sa lain-lain nga area di nimo siyang makita nga epektibo, o Diyos. Palayog, giyahay siya, kuban siyang pamilya nga nasa Kenya, o sa tanan niya mga request, o Diyos, ikaw unta magpadayon sa pagduol kaniya. O labaw na, o Diyos, ginaampo usab na mo si Jean Caldena. Gadoon na usab siya, assessment, ugma. Amahan, nagaduol ng panahon, hatagi siya ang igo ng panahon, aron siya mahimong mamaandam alang sa assessment ugma. Nahibulo kami nga ang mga tao nga maduol kanimo, hatagan giyod ni mo kaalam. O sa pinasahig, ginaampo usab na mo si Shalani Jane, Shanili Jane, nga doon ay diferensya sa kasing-kasing aman. Mga balatian, nakapahasol ka na mo, nakahatag o gaguol o sahay sa mong tibok pamilya. Apan ang mga saad nga imong gimpang hatag ka ng Diyos, among dawaton, among usap ginaampo, si Andy Jilin Formentera, nga nausap ka sa LTMPC, na doon na siya gibati usap ka ng Diyos. Paliyog, hatagi sila kaayuhan, tanong nagbalatian ka ron. Susama kanila gibati og ang uban usab Dios kato mga tao nga gikinahanglan ang imong paghikap karon. Bisitay sila kani among dugang nga pangandoy o Dios nga kung kami magapadayon sa pagserbisyo kanimo, ang amo untang relasyon usab kanimo og sa mga sige tao mamahimong maglig-on tungod kay ikaw nani amang kanamo. Salamat o Dios padung sa pagampo. Dawata kami nga pinasaylo sa matabangan sa ngalan ni Jesus amon luwas. Amen.
Amen.
Higala. Sa pagpadayon, aduna kita'y pinasahig ng musika alang kalinyo. Please, listen to this, listen to the words. Kaya, niya na ang Let's Pray Music.
Salamat no, the flock. It's very inspiring, mga gala, seeing children sing for the Lord. So thank you, guys. It inspires young people and old people to do the same. So karon mga higala, let's recap ang ato ang kuano discussion. So katong sa karon lang, our first principle, listening a big deal. Second is that pride is a block to know God. So for the third point, Ate Ivan, what's our third point?
You guys are so amazing. Our third point po, it's heart evaluation. Yeah.
So, evaluate the heart. Now, before that, atong isgutan, how can we evaluate the heart? Mga personal na to views concerning how to evaluate the heart. So, which pa? One of you two will start? Okay,
bye. Landa mo na ako. Okay, so that means ako. In my personal experience, like, every day, nabasahin man gud ni ako nga quote, so ako na lang pong basahan, di ba? You will receive more strength by spending 1 hour each day in meditation, mourning over your failings and heart corruptions, and pleading for God's pardoning love and the assurance of sin forgiven, than you would by spending many hours and days making yourself acquainted with every objection of to our faith and the most powerful evidences in favor of our faith. So when I read this quote, I also tried to apply it na, okay, dili, bisag dili 1 hour, bisag 10 minutes lang each day nga. O, kanang, ginahuna na ako unsa ako ang sayup yesterday or the day after nga, Lord, how can you work on that? What verse can I take? Anike. Of course, we're young people, we're growing, and this is not a perfect world. So there's a big tendency yun nga makasala. So it comes with that.
So thanks to Aten. So ako po, when I started like doing this thing, heart searching bitaw, I really try to like have okay. Before that point, no, we have a caller on the line, mga higala. So, hello, good morning.
Ma'am Catherine Torillo. Torillo. Yes, good morning, Ma'am Catherine. Welcome to Let's Pray. Yes, morning.
Morning.
Good morning, madam. Yes, good morning. Tagasa ka si Ma'am Catherine? Tagayan di oro. Okay, go ahead, Ma'am Catherine. We will hear from you. Okay.
Amen.
Sige, thank you. Maraming salamat. Okay, daking salamat sa.
Wow, she went nice. Free.
That was the
God.
First time that we had someone on air praying.
Thank you.
So, thank you so much. Kinsa to ang let I think mo to ang a kid or sa to siya.
Yeah.
But anyways, daking salamat kayo, Ma'am Catherine, and to the family nga naas inyong kauban karon. And we will pray for everybody. Sa inyong mga gipray, we will pray it also. But before that, let's proceed now to our discussion. But going back, thank you so much, Ma'am Catherine. We will keep in touch with you. We'll keep in prayer for you. Go ahead, Sean.
Thank you. So when we katong point bang a heart evaluation, when I was starting to realize this part, it's critical. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga no, I cannot be my own standard. I cannot like search myself. I'm human, and there are things that is hidden. And usahay para sa ako, it was okay. it was like basic okay ra ni siya. And there are really points kunya. It's hidden from my own eyes. I really do not know if this is correct in the eyes of God. So in times of heart searching, I really see to it na. I read the Bible and then I try to turn my eyes upon Jesus. What was he doing? How was his heart? He was like the standard. He was like the main. How was his heart? And if in that case, there's like this praying, search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts and see if there be any wicked way in me and lead me in the way everlasting. So that's a critical part. Lord, search me.
Yeah, and also sa ako sa mga point, sa ako po sa mga sender, as ako ang sa ako opinion when we say heart evaluation, examine, we talk about heart. What is the desire of the heart? If atong desire's heart is still on the world or still against the will of God, then that is at least makita nato makikilaan. Nga doon lagi ang atong heart diferensyado pa rin gapon.
Yes.
Heart. Pero sa'yo, ang desire sa tao will overlap the desire of God to us. So, makita po, makikisunan, heart evaluation, muna, I think it's found in 1 Corinthians that examine the heart, examine the heart of God. I think that is in 1 Corinthians. Yeah, we want God to examine our hearts kung unsa bagid ang atong heart desire, makikisunan. If atong heart desire is still maugid ang pag to commit sin, ragiha po, so on, then let's atong paningkamutan, atong i-twist na siya itong desire from our own desire or to God, how can we plead God? No. How can we please God concerning sa atong ipagbati karon? So, makiksunan, if you have a heart full of desires of the flesh and full desires of the world, atong panigamutan. Let's make now this time that our hearts will please God. Aron isab itang soon. That the Holy Spirit will not dwell to a people nga aduna usab mga selfish or aduna gyapon mga sins within itself.
And this boils down to kanang heart evaluation will lead pride to be gone.
Yeah.
And then we now try to listen to God. Okay. So this is like, this was the last point, but I think this is like the first nga nato buhato, no, for us to know how to listen to God, for us to know how to set ourselves aside. This is very critical. Heart evaluation, mga higala, no?
Yeah, okay. So makikisulan, sa dilipata, gamay nila itong time, sa buhatan itong special nga pag-ampo ang ato ang mga last round sa ato ang prayer request. Gikan ka na ako, ninyo siya, good morning. I would like to request a special prayer for my niece, Dr. Evelyn Pipito. She's suffering from terminal illness. This is from Mrs. Irene Biniga. Actually, this was prayed before, so we will still keep on praying for her. So, next.
Okay, diri po, coming from 784. Happy morning. Please pray sa akong anak si Bibay nga maulian na siya sa iyang gibati. Nagbuntag siya, wala makatulog tungod sa iyang ubo. Thank you and more power. We also have from Cheryl Imfil, requesting for good health to my family ug mapaduol unta mi ug ayo sa Ginoo.
And I have two prayers here. Good morning, palihog ko dada sa inyong pag-ampo si Jaja Valero. Hinaot pinaagi sa inyong tabang sa pag-ampo. Kaluoy sa Diyos nga mawala ang iyang ubo ug sipon ug may dutay nga hilana at igsuon ni Jesu Kristo. Okay, yeah, Sean, we have, usually po when we have ubo, sipon or gamay nga hilanat, we do this herbal thing. It's called Russian penicillin. We will try to put it online sa iyang ingredients, no? But you can also search this online, Russian penicillin.
It's a natural way.
Yeah, it's very effective. And then the other one, good morning. Let's pray, Philippines. Palihog ko apil sa inyo pag-ampo. Ang akong pagmangkon nga maapil sa civil service. And it's happening today. His name is Nelvin. So we'll pray for you.
Okay, so, matigilan. Well, we will buhatan espesyal ng pag-ampo. I think Ivan will start. Sean, and I will still be the last. So, magigilan, please join us sa atong katapusan ng rounds ng prayer. So, please, be with us. Atong yun, we will start. Okay?
Okay, let's bow our heads. In the presence of a God infinite, holy, who can move things all throughout the universe, Father, we bring these people who have bring their requests. We would like to bring this back to you. First off, we have here Jaja. I think it's a child. Father, aduna sila'y sakit. Malawas no, na'y ubo, sipon, ug hilanat. These are very typical, especially in our tropical country. So I pray, Father, that you would give wisdom to the mother and to the family to take care of this precious gift, that you'd also touch them, and especially the child, that the health would bring into its strength. And also, Father, I'd like to pray for Nelvin. He's one of those takers currents of civil service. I pray, O God, that your will be established in his life, whatever the results of the exam. His faith could grow more in you and mapanalanginan ang iyang mga family usab. We bring this in the name of Jesus Christ.
In continuation, Father in heaven, thank you so much for the realization today that we have to humbly come to you in surrendering ourselves also, dear Lord, of whatever we have taken into ourselves. Father, we'd like to ask for forgiveness, and we'd also like to remind that we are not holy people. We are not people na among prayers lang ang madungog, but hence, this is a way for other people, for us also to learn more, to come personally in prayer with you. And so, dear Lord, we'd like to pray for Bibay nga naa siya'y ubo. Father, one way of combating diseases is like strengthening the immune system. So be with Bibay's mother, bless her, give her wisdom, give her the financial aid. Also, para makapalit siya veggies and fruits also for her anak nga maayos siya. And Father, there are also natural ways nga pwede maundang ang dili na ma-worsen ng ubo. So we would upload it sa Facebook later. I'd hope also nga the mother, the father will be able to check it up para pod sa ilahang anak. So this is very good, Lord, because natural way will be best for the body, hence protecting the body also from synthetic nga pwede nga naay mga side effects, especially nga bata pa si Bibay. We'd also like to pray for Cheryl Imphil nga niyang gina-pray ang iyang family with good health. Dear Lord, this is your will. It's your will for us to be physically fit, above all, be spiritually fit also. So, dear Lord, be with our family, touch the hearts of every member, help them to understand each other, how to communicate better, and bless them, dear Lord, to come together in prayer to you, because in prayer, our hearts will be lifted up and we will see the greatness of your Son also, Jesus. Now, Father, I pray also that you are coming. This world is not getting any better. So help us to prepare our hearts, our families, of your soon return. This is our prayer above anything else. This I pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Sa pagpadayon, O Diyos, nimintak na. Kung ano naman kayo nakita ng mabuling sa mukasing-kasing karoon, O Diyos, palihog papaan. Aron ang among pag-ampo, madungos lang itong trono. Amahan, nimimatak na ang, doon na kami pinasahig ng pag-ampo si Doktora Evelyn Pipito. Nahibalo ikaw, Aman, siyang gibati ngayang gihambing karon, balatian, diin, usahay, maghatag kayo di siya o kahadlok sa kasing-kasing tungod kay mga butang, lisod alang ka na mo sa mga tawhanong prinsipyo sa tawhanong pagtanaw, lisod kayo, Diyos. Apan walay balatian niya. Kung ikaw na maghikap, O Diyos, na magapabilin tungod kay tanan balatian, kung ikaw na maghikap, kung ikaw na ang magapahawa nini, tanan balatian, magalupad, O Diyos, maghawa sa tanan kung asa sila nagadangup ka, O Diyos. Kaya nahibalo kami, ikaw ang labing magagawang sanan, ikaw ang daku ug inilang ang manilambal, palayo ka man, karuntak na, himuang, himuunin mo ang doktor, mga nurses, mga tanan gamit, mga bidisina ang iyang pagkatumaron, O Diyos. Mahimong extension si imong kamot sa pag-ayo ni Doktora Evelyn Pipito. Tabangi siya man, o kung siya man karon ani ana sa safe nga kondisyon, palihog, hatagi siya o panahon na rin siya makarecover pa man. Amo sa ginaampo, tanan na mo ang mga viewers karon nga nagtanaw. Manaaman sulod sa Pilipinas o layo sa Pilipinas, na naminaw na barikaha sila karon through Hope Video, palihog o Diyos, giyahi sila. Hatagi sila kasulbaran sila mga problema. Hibulo kami. Kaming tanan ni kalibutan, adunay problema. Apan ang problema, gamay lang siya tungod kay ikaw, maong dako nga Diyos. Dako nga maghari sa tibuok kalibutan, apan daw susama kagamay, nga nipuyo sulod sa mong kasing-kasing. Salamat o Diyos sa imong dako nga gahom. Salamat sa imong gugma, panalangin niya mga sponsors, ang Hope Channel as a whole. Salamat sa padayon sa pagpanalangin usab sa Let's Pray Pilipinas. Among itugyan kaning tanan tungod lamang sa ngalan o gahom ni Jesus among personal manluwas. Amen.
Amen.
Higala, aduna kita prayer challenge nga atong pagabatan. Sean, prayer challenge.
So for our prayer challenge kaganina, no, I was able to mention a verse. So please write it down, Psalm 139, 23, and 24. So muna siya atong prayer challenge. We should pray for prayerfully ask the Lord to search our heart. Mga higala, wala na gilaing panahon to do this but now. So I hope and I pray that we will be able to do this today, mga higala.
Thank you so much, Ivan
May.
Thank
you, Ate Ivan. For...
Yes, thank you so much. You can greet your mother.
Yes.
Father.
I did.
Okay, so you did. So anyways, makigilaan, salamat gayon sa itong mga viewers abroad from the United States, through the Middle East, through the Australia, to the Europe. Tanan ka mo diha may suon o sa itong mga friends usab nga naa within here sa Philippines. Nagtanaw through Facebook and nagpaminaw through Hope Radio or katanaw mga suon through television screens. Salamat
yung
suon. Mag-init na ita karong umalabot nga Sabado o Domingo po sa igala. Ayaw yung kalimte nga ang pag-ampo ngayon, maura yun ni atong butang ang itong kuptan. Kaya pag-ampo, pag-istorya sa itong Ginoo. Busa, are you ready to learn more about the biggest blocks?
for God to answer our prayers. Mga higala, watch us again for our next episode. Ooh, it will be exciting, so we will be excited to see you also next week, Saturday, Sunday, 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. Diri lang sa Let's Pray Pilipinas!
If you have been blessed by this program, share hope and help us continue to bring hope everywhere. Send your donations to South Philippine Union Conference through any of the bank details shown here. Hope Channel, sharing love, changing lives.